Hello students, today we will begin with a new chapter and the name of chapter is circles. So quadrilateral BCGF is cyclic. Why? Because BCGF points are coincyclic. Now if this quadrilateral is cyclic, I can say this angle congruent to this angle, BCGF cyclic, exterior angle, interior angle. Therefore, I can write angle ABC is equal to angle CGF. Equation number one, exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral theorem. Same way, even this quadrilateral will be cyclic. Why? Because points are coincyclic. So I write down points. Which points? C, B, E, G are coincyclic. Therefore, quadrilateral C, B, E, G becomes cyclic. Now, if this figure is cyclic, right? So you can observe this angle, which is an exterior angle. Exterior angle, interior angle, angle opposite to interior angle, these two angles will be equal. Therefore, we can say that angle ADC is equal to angle CGE. Equation number 2. The reason for this also is exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral theorem. So we have two equations now. Now I'm adding these two equations. So I'll get, therefore, angle ABC plus angle ADC equals to angle CGF plus angle CGE. This is our equation number 3. How we got this equation? By adding first and second. So we got angle ABC plus angle ADC is equal to angle CGF plus angle CGE. This is our equation number 3. Now, quadrilateral ABCD is cyclic. This is given to us. In the question itself, it is mentioned ABCD is cyclic. Therefore, angle ABC plus angle ADC should be how much? 180 degree. Equation number 4. Reason for this is cyclic quadrilateral theorem. So we are going back to cyclic quadrilateral theorem. Cyclic quadrilateral theorem, in a cyclic quadrilateral, opposite angle ka sum 180. Sum of opposite angles are supplementary. When you add opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral, your answer will be 180 degree. So we got angle ABC plus angle ADC as 180 degree. Third and fourth now. Equation number 3, equation number 4. Third says ABC, ADC is equal to this two. Fourth says ABC, ADC is equal to 180. Result, these two angles 180 degree. Therefore, I can write angle CGF plus angle CGE is equal to 180 degree. Now again, we have to look at the figure. Angle CGF. Angle CGF. Angle CGE. CGE. We are getting sum of these two angles as 180 degree. Now when we are getting this angle as 180 degree, obviously this line is a straight line. Right? When a line is straight, when it makes 180 degree angle, result is F, G, E. Now we have to go back to the question. Question is, we need to prove circumcircles intersect at point G. So when we are getting a straight line FGE Obviously, these two circumcircles are intersecting at point G. This is our answer. So next we'll start problem set question number 13. Question is, prove that, I'll write the question also, prove that the quadrilateral formed by angle bisectors of a cyclic quadrilateral is also cyclic. So question given to us that there is a quadrilateral drawn and this quadrilateral is cyclic. If I name this as ABCD, so there is a quadrilateral given ABCD. Now what I am doing is I am drawing the angle bisectors. When I am saying angle bisector, I have taken these two angles equal. This side also. Then I am also drawing bisector for angle D and bisector for angle B. So I'll mark remaining two angles also. So this angle is equal, even this side, these two angles are equal. Why? Because it is given to us, formed by angle bisectors. So four angle bisectors. So I'll name resultant quadrilateral as PQRS. So it is known to us, ABCD is cyclic. That time also I told you, not necessary that there has to be a quadrilateral outside. But just for better imagination, I'll show you that there is a quadrilateral outside ABCD. So easy for us to make out that it is a cyclic. So circle is there, one quadrilateral is there, four bisectors. Question asked to us, we need to prove PQRS is cyclic quadrilateral. So given to us, quadrilateral ABCD cyclic. Then given to us, AP, BP or BS also you can write, CR and BR are angle bisectors, are given to us angle bisectors. To prove quadrilateral PQRS is cyclic, we'll start with the proof now. Angle bisector. Clear? AP is angle bisector of angle A. This is given to us. Therefore, we can write, if you look at, this is your angle BAQ. Therefore, we can write angle DAQ is equal to half angle DAQ is what? Half of angle A, right? Is half of angle A because it's an angle bisector. Equation number one. Clear? Then after that, we can also make out angle BR, or we'll start with the BP only, BP angle bisector of angle B. therefore we can write if BP is an angle bisector, obviously angle CBS will be half of angle B. Second equation, same way, CR, angle bisector. When CR is angle bisector of angle C, we can write, if CR is angle bisector of angle C, we can write angle BCS. We can write angle BCS as half of angle C. Third equation, DR, angle bisector. Now DR is angle bisector of which angle? Angle D. This is given to us. So when DR is angle bisector, we can write angle ADQ as half of angle D. Equation number 4. Right, we got 4 equations now. Now, concentrate on this triangle. In this triangle, if you look at, there are 3 sides, there are 3 angles. This is half angle A, half angle D, plus angle Q. Can we make out? Half angle A, half angle D, plus angle Q. The sum should be 180 degree. Half angle A, half angle D, plus angle Q. Sum has to be 180 degree. Now, I will take triangle AD, triangle AQD. In triangle AQD, if you look at angle DAQ plus angle, this is your angle ADQ plus angle Q equals to 180 degree. Sum of angle of a triangle 180 degree. Now DAQ is half of angle A, therefore half angle A. ADQ, half of angle D, plus half angle D, plus angle Q, 180 degree. This we got from first and fourth. From equation number 1 and 4 we got this. Therefore, half common angle A plus angle D plus angle Q is equal to 180 degree. Now angle A plus angle D, we have written in bracket, half of this is 180 degree. This is our equation number 5. Also, look at this triangle now. Which one? Triangle BSC. In triangle BSC, angle CBS, right? Angle CBS plus angle BCS plus angle S is 180 degree. Reason is sum of angle of a triangle 180 degree. Now instead of CBS, we can write half angle B. Instead of BCS, we can write half angle C plus angle S 180 degree. This we got from second and third. From equation number second and third, we got this result. Therefore, half angle B plus angle C plus angle S, 180 degree. This is equation number 6. Now we'll add 5th and 6th. Therefore, if I'm adding 5th and 6th, I can take half common. In bracket, we'll get A plus B plus C plus D plus angle Q plus angle S is equal to 180 plus 180, 360. This we got by adding 5th and 6th. Add 5th equation and 6th equation. Equals to. Now if you look at, if you are going further, so this will give you angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D. This is your angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D. Don't you think if you add all 4 angles, you will get what? 360. Therefore, half of 360 degree plus angle Q plus angle S is equal to 360 degree. Half of 360 is 180 degree plus angle Q plus angle S is equal to 360 degree. Now if I bring 180 other side, we'll get angle Q plus angle S is equal to 180 degree. Angle Q plus angle S is equal to 180 degree. Quadrilateral PQRS, we have got angle Q plus angle S as 180 degree. Now I'm going back to converse of cyclic quadrilateral theorem, which says that if sum of opposite angle is equal to 180 degree, quadrilateral is cyclic. Therefore, I can say quadrilateral PQRS is cyclic. Reason is converse of cyclic quadrilateral theorem. Converse of cyclic quadrilateral theorem. So in this sum, there were four angle bisectors given. What we have done is property of angle bisector four times in four equations. Then we have applied sum of angle of a triangle 180 degree. Then we have replaced values. We got an equation. In equation, we have used a property. All four angles of a cyclic quadrilateral is 360 degree. So instead of A, B, C, D, we replaced it by 360 degree. Then by solving it, we got the answer. Question number 16 of problem set. Question given to you this way. There is one isosceles triangle. PQR. Now in this isosceles triangle, within there is ST and there is one cyclic quadrilateral which is passing through point Q and R. So over here there are two points S and T. This is your point S, this is your point T. So given to us PQR, isosceles triangle PQ is equal to PR. Angle P 50 degree. Angle P value is given to us 50 degree. We need to find out angle PST. This angle is 50 degree. Angle PST we need to find out. Solution. So we'll start with the solution for this. In triangle PQR, if you look at angle P plus angle Q plus angle R gives you 180 degree. Sum of three angles of a triangle 180 degree. I'll write the reason for this. Therefore, 50 degree plus angle Q plus angle R 180 degree. Therefore, angle Q plus angle R equals to 180 minus 50. Angle Q plus angle R is equal to 180 degree. First equation. Now, PQ is equal to PR given to us. It's an isosceles triangle. Therefore, angle Q is equal to angle R. This is our second equation. Therefore, if angle Q is equal to angle R, I can write sum of two angles 130 degree and both the angles are equal. Therefore, I can write angle Q is equal to angle R is equal to 65 degree. From 1 and 2, I name this as third equation. Slightly, I want to speak more on this. Two numbers, if sum is 100, two numbers, if sum is 100 and both are equal, numbers would be 50-50. Two numbers, sum is 80 and they are equal, numbers will be 40-40. Two angles, sum is 90 degree, both are equal, angles will be 45-45.
two angles, sum is 130 degree. Both angles equal. So each angle 65 degree. I think this is clear now. How we got 65 degree Q and R. Now again, STRQ, cyclic. Why? Because points are coincyclic. Points are coincyclic, all points are on a cyclic quadrilateral. Therefore, angle PST is an exterior angle, interior angle, opposite interior angle, angle PST is equal to angle R, right? But angle R is 65 degree, therefore angle PST is equal to 65 degree. This we got from third equation. This is what we were looking for. Next we'll start question number 17th of problem 6. Now in this sum, question goes this way. Circle. Inside a circle, there is a figure drawn. Inside a circle, there is a figure drawn. And given to us that ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram, and this point is P. ABCD parallelogram, then mention to us BABP, BAB cuts BC at point P. We need to prove BC is equal to DP. We need to prove BC is equal to DP. We'll start with the proof of this. First thing, given to us, ABCD is a parallelogram. Given. If someone says parallelogram, thoughts which should come in my mind, opposite sides are parallel, opposite sides are congruent, diagonals bisect each other, opposite angles are congruent. Again, opposite sides are parallel, opposite sides are congruent, diagonals bisect each other, opposite angles congruent. Parallelogram, these many thoughts should come in my mind. Kya kya? Parallelogram mein opposite sides parallel hai, opposite sides congruent hai, opposite angles congruent hai, diagonals bisect each other hota hai. Think it off. If I say rectangle, what thought should come in your mind? If I say square, to aapke dimag mein kya kya aana chahiye? Same way, rhombus, trapezium. So you should be very thorough with all this. Parallelogram, rectangle, rhombus, square. Take 10 minutes time, try to recapitulate everything. Parallelogram, things in your mind, rectangle, all points in your mind, rhombus properties, kya kya, everything should come in your mind. Example, I'll take rhombus. Rhombus, opposite sides are congruent, rhombus, diagonals bisect each other, rhombus, again, rhombus, all sides are congruent, diagonals bisect each other, right? When I say square, all sides are congruent, all angles are right angle. Diagonals bisect each other, diagonals congruent. When I say rectangle, again, things should come in your mind. So, take 5-10 minutes time, take a pencil, take a notebook, write rectangle, write all properties, write square, write all properties, close your notebook, think it off, make sure you know all concepts, you know all properties of all diagrams, right? ABCD is a parallelogram. Now, when ABCD is a parallelogram, opposite angles are congruent. Therefore, I can write angle A congruent angle C. First equation. Opposite angles are congruent in a parallelogram. Then, after this, we can make out it's a cyclic quadrilateral. We can make out it's a cyclic quadrilateral. Why? Because points are coincyclic. So, I write down points. Which points? A, B, P, D, coincyclic. This is given to us. Therefore, quadrilateral ABPD becomes cyclic. Now, if ABPD is cyclic, you can identify these two angles are equal. Exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral theorem. Therefore, we can write angle BPC congruent angle A. Equation number 2. Exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral. Therefore, look at first and second. Angle C, angle BPC, angle A, angle A. Now these two angles equal. Result, these two angles equal. Therefore, we can say angle BPC congruent angle C from 1 and 2. Now when these two base angles equal, result is opposite sides equal, isosceles triangle theorem. Therefore, we can say BC congruent BP. Reason, sides opposite to congruent angles. Angles are equal, sides are equal. So if you look at two properties were used. One, cyclic quadrilateral, that is exterior angle. Second, isosceles triangle theorem. Ek humne isosceles use kiya, dusra exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral theorem use kiya. And that is how we have got the answer. So we'll take one more sum. That is your question number 18. Problem set only we are taking. Your sum number, I guess, is question number 20 it is. We'll take 20th sum from problem set. So figure is this way. There are two circles. These two circles are intersecting at point A and B. From A, a line is drawn. From B also, there is a line drawn. These two lines are intersecting. And names given as CD and MN. CD and MN, name given. So, given to us, two circles intersect each other in point A and B, secant through A and B. Intersect circle in CD and MN, we need to prove CM parallel to BN. यहाँ पे देखो अभी CM और DN हमको parallel prove करना है. Now we know two lines कभी parallel होती हैं. Two lines parallel होती हैं या तो alternate angle से, corresponding angle से, या फिर interior angle test. When I am talking of two lines, obviously we have also done basic proportionality theorem. जहाँ पे अगर एक triangle है, तो हम लोग बोल सकते हैं lines parallel हो जाती हैं, right? Sides अगर proportion में है तो. But we can make out यहाँ पे triangle का there is no condition where we can find out there is a triangle. So these two lines will be parallel. Don't you think? ये दोनों line parallel होंगी. अगर हम CD को transversal लेके चलते हैं. If we take CD as a transversal और ये दोनों line, ये दोनों angle का sum अगर 180 हो गया, तो lines parallel हो गई. Which two angles? अगर angle C plus angle D का sum 180 हो गया, तो lines parallel हो गई, जिसमें CD transversal है. Proof of this. So first of all, I am going to join AB. Construction, join AB. Proof of this now. Points A, B, M, C coincide. Again, I am going to tell you when question में directly दिया नहीं है cyclic quadrilateral और हमको दिया हुआ points और हमको मालूम है point circle के ऊपर है. Always use this point. Always write this statement which says points A, B, M and C are coincyclic. Coincyclic का meaning ये होता है कि point circle के ऊपर है. और अगर point circle के ऊपर है, we can directly come to conclusion कि जो figure बन रहा है वो cyclic है. Because that is the definition. That is what we know. कि कोई भी point अगर circle के ऊपर है, वो points को अगर हमने join किया, तो हमको cyclic quadrilateral मिलता है. So A, B, M, C, cyclic. Now if this is a cyclic quadrilateral, right? If this is a cyclic quadrilateral, I can say that angle ABM, angle ABN equals to angle C. First equation, exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral theorem. Exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral theorem. Then, even points A, B, N, D are coincyclic. These four points are also coincyclic. Why? Because they are lying on the circle. Result. Therefore, I can say that quadrilateral A, B, and D is cyclic. So over here also I have to mention point A, B, M, C is coincyclic. Therefore, quadrilateral A, B, M, C becomes cyclic. If cyclic, we got this result. Same way, points A, B, and D coincyclic. Therefore, I got this result. Result is A, B, and D is cyclic. Therefore, now if this is cyclic, these two angles will be equal. Like last time. Last time it was these two angles. This time it is these two angles. Therefore, I can say angle ABM equals to angle D, equation 2, exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral theorem. We got two equations now. I'm adding these two equations. Therefore, angle ABN plus angle ABM is equal to angle C plus angle D. Add first and second equation. We name this as third equation. Now, look at this. ABM, ABN, it's a linear pair, so angle should be 180 degree. Sum of these two angles should be 180. Angle ABN plus angle ABM equals to 180 degree. Reason is linear pair. Equation number 4. Third and fourth. ABN, ABM, 180 degree. Therefore, 180 degree is equal to angle C plus angle D. This we got from third and fourth. Now, here is the point. When I begin this sum, I have told you when two lines are parallel. Abhi yahan par, angle C plus angle D, hum logon ko sum mil gaya 180. Agar ye dono angle ka sum 180 hai aur ye transversal hai, obviously line parallel ho gayi. Therefore, we can say CM parallel to BN. Interior angle test. By interior angle test, हम लोगों को आंसर आ गया कि ये दोनों लाइन पैरेलल हैं. Now look at the flow again. How we have done this sum? Cyclic quadrilateral points coincyclic है. Cyclic हो गया. Exterior angle, interior angle, same way points coincyclic है. Cyclic quadrilateral, exterior angle, interior angle. Then we have added two equation. This angle plus this angle equals to these two angles. But sum of these two is 180 because of linear pair. That means sum of these two is 180. If 180, interior angle test, lines parallel.